What's up, dudes and dudettes of the internet? My name's Ethan. We are back again for some more No Man's Sky, a space exploration journey where no one has gone before. How y'all doing today, folks? Hope you're doing fantastically wonderful. Hope this video makes your day even better, man. Alive, everybody. I have been busy. So, I got so many things to tell you all about. Seriously, it's absolutely crazy. Okay, so we reached over 100 words with our alien language because I've been exploring this planet like a psychopath. And don't worry, we're going to be heading off of this planet today because I just figured something else out as far as completing the entire planet goes, thanks to all of you. Then we also have a whole bunch more inventory slots, which inventory slots are starting to cost 200,000, which means that the next one's probably gonna be 210,000. I lost all my money because of all the other things that we've gotten. We got some new suit upgrades, which I'll show you in a minute. We have a new tool as well. We ended up getting one. Our original tool was 9 slots, then we got one that was 12, and then I found another one that was the same as this new tool that was 14. So, ignore that too. Yeah. So here's our new tool. You can see I've got it all decked out. We need some chrysonite though in order to get the third version of the this beam focus thing, which once we end up getting enough chrysonite, I'll probably end up getting rid of this combat one because we don't really fight that much right now, and then just get the other one for resource gathering. Seriously, we gather resources so quickly now, and then also, of course, salvaged another ship. This one's got the same slots that our DLC ship had once upon a time, but this one just looks beautiful. It's much better than the battery one that we ended up having. But look at this. Look how fast we mine that, man. And not to mention, look at our coolant on it too. Like, it really just does not go, like, it doesn't overheat like at all. Then also, here's something that was very, very interesting. I wish I got this on camera. Sorry, I didn't really know that something this exciting could end up happening. We got recipes. Crafting recipes, everybody. So we actually, not only, I think, did we have suspension fluid? No, we didn't have that on camera. So we have suspension fluid now. We can craft that. And then we also have the antimatter. Ka-ching! Because now, with the antimatter, like, the way that works, we craft suspension fluid for carbon, then the electronic vapor for one suspension fluid and plutonium, that's still pretty cheap, and then the antimatter is heridium, which we've got plenty on this planet, and zinc. Zinc is a little bit more hard to come by because we have to farm it from plants and stuff like that, but then once we get that, we can create a warp cell with a couple of thamium, which is very, very easy to get, and now, if you'll look at our ship over here, we're actually full fuel on our hyperdrive. Now, granted, we're still going to explore a couple more planets in this system, but I just wanted to let you know about that. And then we also have, what was the other weird item that we got? We got dynamic resonator, which is apparently a device necessary in the construction of many technologies that aid in exploration of the galaxy. I don't know. I'm guessing it's some later tiered thing. And then we also ended up getting, where is it? Power gel. So now we can actually craft this. And then also for our suit, we've got better sprinting. We've got better energy on our life support, which I guess I never really mentioned that, just for anyone that doesn't actually have this game, because I know a lot of you, like, your computers can't handle it and stuff like that, and that's why you watch, which I'm all about that. But as we have more life support, pretty much as we're standing outside of our ship, I guess it's realistic, where our life support is constantly draining all the time, no matter what, because it's like our life support of our suit, right? So now that we've got the extra life support, huh? I thought the music was kicking up. We can go on the planet, like, really, really easy. And as far as planet exploration goes, I've been exploring all over the place. Turns out that the only, you were letting me know about this, folks. Turns out that the only way that you can max out a planet is just by identifying all of the species. And as you see, we're missing two, and I have absolutely no idea where they are. Like, seriously, I've already been exploring this planet for probably at least, like, a few hours, that's for sure. Like, 3 hours plus, I would say. So anyways, we're gonna finally end up heading off world. I would very much appreciate it as well. I always forget to say it at the beginning. But would you hit that like button for me? Helps me out more than you know, folks. And let's get out of here. and finally get off this Uggles planet and find another one. We are going to name some stuff at the end of the episode, folks, just because I want to get things on the move here. But as we end up naming things for those that are just tuning in, should we steal from these guys? Probably not. We're not really prepared for combat. But should we go to the volcanic planet? We probably could. But that's okay. Let's check this one out because this one seems kind of cool. So anyways, we name stuff. Leave comments down below with names and stuff like that that you want me to put in the videos, and eventually it will show up. As for today, oops, we gotta go into hyperdrive. As for today, we'll probably end up doing those near the end of the video. I probably want to get into a habit of just doing that in general, just so that we can kind of spend like the episode talking about relevant things and then just kind of save the end for the special stuff. So anyways, finally getting off world. And it's good that I experienced that. It's good that I know that now, because now, like, as I say at the beginning of the series, don't get married to a planet. That's what I was doing. I was getting married to that planet. I was getting addicted to actually exploring that one single planet. And although it was extremely profitable, yes, I like exploring, and I like checking out new areas and new technologies and just all sorts of special planets and stuff like that. Now, granted, if we end up finding a planet that's particularly beautiful, we may end up being on it for a very long time. Yes. What's beeping? That was weird. But not necessarily like staying on the same planet for a million zillion years. Like, we might not stay on a planet as long as we did that last one, at least for a long time. And now that we also have our hyperdrive, it does mean that we can finally go down, go to other systems very, very easily and kind of follow like the main quest line to the center of the galaxy, just because I've been hearing, not that I want to explore any of that stuff. Like, I'm perfectly fine with what we're doing right now. I don't really want to go to any, to the center of the galaxy or anything. I'm just saying, frame dip. I'm just saying that I know, not from spoilers and stuff like that, just because that's how games are designed, I know that there's probably like tons and tons and tons and tons of resources and items and stuff like that that are kind of like required that we'll end up getting just by going to this era of the universe, right? So we've got, what is that ore right there? I want to take a peek, because the floating rocks, that's always copper. Oh, at least we got some vegetation on this one. Aha! And then it's shininess. So there's low security, temperate, frequent flora, numerous stuff. I wanted to also show that off as well, that we actually, for our suit, have a whole bunch. Like, we have fire survival, toxin, ice, which we need to still get that Gravitino ball, which I'm assuming is going to be a crafting recipe we haven't come across. And then we also have, this lets us breathe underwater for extended periods of time, and this does the exact same thing. So I guess it's like an extended version of that. And then we've got for radiation, and then just a shield boost in general, which I guess would be good for fighting and exploration and junk like that, right? Let's try and scan this dumb rock. Oh man, but I've been having an absolute blast with this game, folks. Hope you've all been enjoying. Now look at this, this is funny. We've seen that exact same plant that we just scanned. That was just a red one. Ooh, aluminium! Yes, 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 yes! See, this is the other big advantage of coming to these other worlds, is I've got plenty of resources. Like, we got plenty of iridium and stuff like that. I needed aluminium bad! So that means we're gonna be able to get ourselves some different upgrades. I don't know if that's necessarily, like, I mean, I have to double check if that was one for... Is that guy trying to fight me? Nah, they don't really care when we're mining ore like this, which makes sense because of the amount of time that it takes, which, as you see right there, I mean, this new multi-tool that we've got is absolutely amazing. Like, look how fast we ended up getting through that. Okay, so let's see what else we got. We got a weird rock plant thing up there. Are these new? Or is that one of the ones that we just scanned? Oh, that's a new one. Okay. There we go. So we got more plant life that we can name. Woohoo. Yeah, so I'm assuming that was something for the multi-tool. Let's actually get rid of this extra combat one, even though, yeah, it's cool for sure, but that's okay. We don't really need it. Aluminium, there it is. So we needed that for the beam coolant, which we're doing fine on the coolant. Doesn't really matter. Crescentite, we need for the extra diamond mining and plutonium, but that's easy to get. I would love to end up getting this one too, so we might end up going for this. Pretty much what this seems to do is the short amount of time that our laser takes to get to its target, this eliminates that. And it's just instant as soon as we pull the trigger, which I guess technically in the long run would end up being worthwhile. But personally speaking, I really would want something like this. Now, granted, because this is the coolant system, we could end up getting rid of this level one coolant system and then putting this other one. So we need more aluminium, a lot more aluminium. And then we need... Oh, that's the combat one. We don't need that. And then Chrysonite, which hopefully this planet ends up having. Don't really know if it's going to, though. But at least we've got that one resource, because we needed that one bad. Now, it seems like that might have actually been the rare resource of the planet, which that's not really good. Also, I don't like how this happens. I don't like how our waypoints are not, like, disappearing off of other planets. I think that could end up becoming very, very tedious if our whole screen is eventually just cluttered with cluttered with stuff from off-world. Maybe that's just kind of how the game works within a system, and then once we end up going to another system, hopefully it all ends up going away. But otherwise, I find it to be a little bit confusing, and I think it can end up being a bit of a problem. So hopefully that'll go away. Ooh, we got weird rainbow plants. These ones we scanned already. However, there was that. A giant seashell. Ooh, and the creatures. Hello, Uggles. It's a dog turtle. And what is that disgusting thing? Oh, there's like two of them. Okay, because that was scaring me for a minute there. I don't like accidentally scanning these things because then they don't go away. Okay, so we got a power canister, save point, and then we're gonna get a bunch of upgrades in here. I also see a red cactus on our left, which I think we ended up scanning one of these puppies. No, not one of these bigger ones. Okay, so we scanned the smaller guys. What the? All these noises are scaring me. So we're gonna get some more space bucks. Oh, never mind, we got a new word. Oh yeah, that one gives a word, and then there's the other one that gives space bucks. Blueprints. Already known, rip me. We're starting to get some pretty high-tiered stuff. Maybe once we get, like, closer to the center of the galaxy, more stuff would ensue. I don't know. Already known. Yeah, I went pretty crazy there, folks, because I really wanted to get that planet out of the way. That was a big reason why I ended up doing that. Ooh. You're not really a new flower, but I guess it's a different color, so the game considers it new. But yeah, I really wanted to get that planet over and done with, folks. I know that we spent a lot of time there, which is fine, don't get me wrong. But yeah, we might not end up doing something like that for a while again, until we end up finding, like, maybe a special planet. Okay, so we got something over here. I'm trying to keep my eyes peeled for aluminum, though. So what is this down here? Looks like it's gonna be a bunch of new stuff. Ooh. And then there's something up on that cliff as well. Oh, that might be some of the aluminium. Is it aluminum? I just see the word and it says aluminium, so that's kind of what I keep thinking, right? When in doubt, follow the rockets. Haha. Okay. There we go. Oh, jeez, that was close. Wait, this is just iron. Aw, man. Was there a resource? Oh, ha, there it is. I knew I saw you. Ooh, aluminium. Yeah, it is aluminium. Okay. Well, either way, we need all the aluminium that we can get. That's a fun word to say. That's why I'm saying it like 50,000 times. Okay. But yeah, we definitely don't really need the coolant system. I mean, as you can see, like, coolant is not really a problem for us anymore. And even then, maybe it's a glitch. I don't know. That they might end up nerfing eventually, but for the time being, we can just end up letting go of our left click, and that just resets the cooldown anyway, so we don't really need it. Oh, beautiful. Give me all that we can get. Yes, please. There we go. Beautiful. Okay, so did we end up getting enough now? Wow. We're not really getting that much from these, are we? Yeah, because we're going to need 200 and then another 100. And that's Christ nice. So yeah, we need 300 total. Yee. Do we end up getting more the same as iron? If we end up... Oh, our inventory's full. That's why. Rip me. Jeez Louise. Let's get rid of these stupid things. We don't need a power canister. I don't care. Oh, man. That's so much of the resource wasted. Oh, dude. No, it just seems to not be giving us much. There, we got a little bit. So the ones on the ground actually weren't giving us any. That's odd. Okay. What was that thing that was nearby? We're going to need this plutonium as well. It was down by our ship. There it is. Because we're kind of on a cliff right here. I'm also kind of getting used to the symbols of all of the items around and stuff like that. Like usually that gold one, the gold bar, is usually zinc, which is a resource that you always need. Ooh, that's a pretty plant. Thank you. You stupid flower. Just kidding, I love you. Mwah. It's a kissing flower. Ooh. All right, we got a new word right over here as well. Yoink. Or. Well, that's a word that we definitely needed for a million years. Where's the thing? There it is. Okay, and what resource is that that's right next to us? Is that gold? It might be. Oh, titanium. Well, that's always a good thing, too. We also got that sucker over there, but that's okay. Instead, we're just going to go in here, get ourselves another word. Thank you. Now, the ice... Is this something? Yeah, we already know that. The ice protection on our suit is actually probably one of the most costly upgrades. And I know for a fact... Now, I got to double check if this is Heridium. I know for a fact that... It costs a lot just because every planet that we've come across at nighttime anyways, yeah, ends up like always cooling us off. So it looks like the ores stay consistent. So that's kind of cool. Like that's kind of what I meant where I'm getting used to the game now, you know, like I'm getting used to the idea that, okay, so now we know that the pillars that look like, well, it's a beautiful blue! Oh, Havoc Physics. Whew. That's happened to me multiple times now. Man, this planet is desolate. Jeez. But yeah, the beautiful blue ore is definitely Heridium that always kind of looks like a big spiring tower. Ay, 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 ay. Well, at least we got something else over here. Most of all, I'm just looking for the extra resource, because rip me for having a full inventory. Oh, man. Because I really want those upgrades, man, because that's going to make things a lot easier for us. So what do we got under here? Oh, we got a little base. Let's check it out. See if we can find a trader. Well, I'm not necessarily a trader. I just mean one of those space frogs. Ow! That's good. Okay. Oh, is that a new plant? Yeah, it is. All right. And what about these rocks? We've scanned these, right? No. Okay. All the rocks. Scan all the rocks. We have to get data. More data. Ooh. Oh, it's one of these bases that's been all infected and stuff. Cool. So as far as the story is concerned... as I've been kind of talking with more hieroglyphs and stuff like that, and these things right here, kind of just more implying that the Sentinels kind of came around, started trying to act like they own the place, against the first spawn of the Gek and stuff like that. So we're probably going to get another piece of lore here. Seems like every time we come to one of these, the lore kind of progresses further. It's not like repeating the same words over and over. Is this what we become? At each turn on my journey, I find only more to taunt or to taint my spirit and my flesh. The fanged maws erupt around me when my back is turned. I hear them chattering and spitting. Sometimes they scream sounds that may be words, perhaps my name. I haven't removed my exosuit in many cycles. I'm afraid to look at my own skin. Okay, I know it will be seething, pus wet and pitted. I have become a vector of infection, the corruption of something ruinous lives in my flesh. Don't come looking for me. Okay, so are we not supposed to be talking to these and they're slowly killing us? Like, seriously. Because that's scaring me, man. New technology, another shield companion. Shield duration and charge capacity is further improved. And then over here is going to be one of those disgusting tentacles, right? Why can we not scan you? I guess because we're indoors. Okay, he's going to attack like he always does. Then we'll just restore our shield, which means that it didn't really do anything. Here's more resources, and I see... Oh, I thought that was another bad guy. Give me the resources. Good. So, ooh, I almost missed this. I didn't notice that those were kind of in this place, too. I may have missed a lot of things, actually. Oh, yeah, I must have missed a lot of things for a very long time, then. All right, well, can't seem to get that one. That's okay. Grab this little save point right here. Ooh, more stuff to check out first. More fascinating beads. I'm slowly trying to get our money back up as well. But yeah, anyways, naming time. Let's name some stuff and then we'll call it for today. So, now that we finally have a new planet, I've been waiting to call one Pizza Planet for a very long time. Toy Story, right? And then we've got an animal that we can name. Let's try on Snake Land. We got anything that we can name? We got a creature? Anything? Anything at all? Here we go. Ugh. Jeez, okay. So this one's by Melissa. We're gonna call it She. And then we've got a couple plants that we can name. We'll call this one by the Vortex. A-R-A-F. Makes me think of ARF. And then we'll call this majestic deer thing Vital Bullet. and then I guess we will name, where is, did we actually seriously not get any outposts on Snake Land? Okay, we'll call this outpost Name Something by Stellarano. And then, by the way, the other Vital Bullet was also by Vortex as well. But anyways, our ship as well, I guess I should have mentioned I'm calling it the SS Jub Jub Mark II, and that name is gonna get considerably long by the end of the series. But yeah, anyway, thanks for watching, folks. Very much appreciate it. Hope you enjoyed. I'm gonna search for a little bit more aluminium and try to get things a little bit more under control, and I'll see you in the next one. Sayonara and stay epic, everybody. Believe in yourself.